lecture series of Mathematics 1. I am Hitesh Manglani, Assistant Professor at LJ Institute of Engineering and Technology. So today we will discuss topic that is convergence and divergence of an infinite series and telescoping series and geometric series of chapter sequence and series. So first of all we will understand infinite series. If we add the terms of an infinite sequence un, where n greater than equal to 1 to infinite, then the expression we will get is u1 plus u2 plus u3 plus so on plus un plus so on, which is known as an infinite series. We can say that series is summation of terms of sequence. Now we will discuss notation of series. So if the series is infinite, then it is denoted by sigma n equal to 1 to infinite un or sigma un. So this is notation of series. If the series is finite, then it is called finite series and is denoted by sigma I equal to 1 to n ui. So this is finite series and its notation is sigma I equal to 1 to n ui. And this is infinite series and its notation is sigma n equal to 1 to infinite un or sigma un. Now we will discuss partial sum. So if sigma n equal to 1 to infinite un is an infinite series, then the partial sum is denoted by Sn and is defined as S1 is equal to u1, where S1 means sum of first term. Then S2 is equal to u1 plus u2. So here S2 is summation of first two terms. Same way S3 is equal to u1 plus u2 plus u3. So meaning of S3 is summation of first three terms. Same way S4 will be u1 plus u2 plus u3 plus u4. So meaning of S4 is summation of first four terms. In general, we can say that Sn is equal to u1 plus u2 plus u3 plus so on plus un. So meaning of Sn is summation of first n terms. So this is equal to sigma I equal to 1 to n ui. These partial sums form a new sequence Sn. Now we will discuss convergence, divergence of an infinite series. So first of all we will discuss convergent series. So the series sigma n equal to 1 to infinite un is convergent if Sn tends to finite unique limit s as n tends to infinite. That is, limit n tends to infinite Sn is equal to s, where s is finite unique limit. So if limit n tends to infinite Sn is equal to s and s is finite unique limit, then we can say that series is convergent. Here S is called sum of the series. So here S is called the sum of series, that is sigma n equal to 1 to infinite un is equal to S. Now we will discuss divergent series. So the series sigma n equal to 1 to infinite un is divergent if Sn tends to plus or minus infinite or limit does not exist. That is, limit n tends to infinite Sn is equal to plus or minus infinite or limit does not exist. So if limit n tends to infinite Sn is equal to plus or minus infinite or limit does not exist, then we can say that series is divergent. Now we will discuss oscillation of an infinite series. So oscillatory series. So the series sigma n equal to 1 to infinite un is oscillatory if Sn does not tend to a unique limit as n tends to infinite. That is, limit n tends to infinite Sn does not exist. So if limit n tends to infinite Sn does not exist, then we can say that series is oscillatory. Now we will discuss properties of series. So if sigma un and sigma vn are two convergent series, then sigma c into un and sigma un plus vn and sigma un minus vn are also convergent, and sigma c into un is equal to c into sigma un, then sigma un plus vn can be written as sigma un plus sigma vn, then sigma un minus vn can be written as sigma un minus sigma vn. Then next property is removal or addition finite number of terms does not affect the convergence of the series. So if we add or remove finite number of terms in the series, then also it will not affect the convergence of series. Now we will discuss example related to this. Show that the telescoping series sigma n equal to 1 to infinite 1 divided by n into n plus 1 is convergent and find its sum. So here un is equal to 1 divided by n into n plus 1. So here this can be written as n plus 1 minus n whole divided by n into n plus 1. Now if we divide individually, so here n plus 1 is divided by n into n plus 1. So here n plus 1 cancel out. So it will be 1 divided by n. Same way here n divided by n into n plus 1. So here n cancel out. So it will be 1 divided by n plus 1. So this is un. Now here we will find out sn. So meaning of sn is summation of first n terms. So sn is equal to u1 plus u2 plus u3 plus so on plus un. So here first of all we will have to find out u1. So to find u1 we will replace n equal to 1 in un. So here if we replace n equal to 1 in un, so here it will be 1 divided by 1 minus 1 divided by 1 plus 1. So 1 divided by 2. So u1 will be 1 minus 1 divided by 2 plus. Now we will have to find u2. So for that we will replace n by 2 in un. So here it will be 1 divided by 2 minus 1 divided by 3. Same way to find u3 we will replace n by 3 in un. So it will be 1 divided by 3 minus 1 divided by 4 plus so on plus un is 1 divided by n minus 1 divided by n plus 1. Now here if we simplify this, then here 1 by 2 1 by 2 cancel out. Then here 1 by 3 cancel out. Then minus 1 by 4 will cancel out with next bracket. In next bracket it will be 1 by 4. So 1 by 4 and 1 by 4 will cancel out. Same way here 1 by n will cancel out with its previous bracket. So finally if we simplify this, then it will be 1 minus 1 divided by n plus 1. So here only first and last term will remain. All other terms will cancel out. Therefore, this type of series is called telescoping series because here only first and last term will remain. So Sn is equal to 1 minus 1 divided by n plus 1, and therefore limit n tends to infinite Sn is equal to limit n tends to infinite. What is Sn? It is 1 minus 1 divided by n plus 1. Now here we will replace n by infinite. So here it will be 1 divided by infinite, and 1 divided by infinite is 0. So it will be 1 minus 0, so which is 1. So this is finite and unique answer. Therefore the given series is convergent and its sum is 1. That is sigma n equal to 1 to infinite 1 divided by n into n plus 1 is equal to 1. Now we will discuss next example. That is, prove that the series sigma n equal to 1 to infinite n cube is divergent. So here un is equal to n cube. So first of all we will have to find out Sn. So here Sn is equal to u1 plus u2 plus u3 plus so on then plus un. So u1 means first term. So to find u1 we will replace n by 1 in un. So here it will be 1 cube. Same way now we will have to find u2. So for u2 we will replace n by 2 in un. So it will be 2 cube. Same way for u3 we will replace n by 3. So it will be 3 cube plus so on plus n cube. Now here we will use the formula of sigma n cube. So we know that sigma n cube is equal to n square into n plus 1 whole square divided by 4. Now we will apply limit n tends to infinite Sn is equal to limit n tends to infinite. Here Sn is n square into n plus 1 whole square divided by 4. Now here we will replace n by infinite. So here if we replace n by infinite, so it will be infinite. So the series is divergent. Now we will discuss the convergence of 1 minus 1 plus 1 minus 1 plus 1 minus 1 plus so on. So here first of all we will have to find out un. So un is equal to minus 1 raised to n plus 1. Because here if we put n equal to 1 in un, so here it will be minus 1 raised to 1 plus 1. So it will be minus 1 whole square. So it will be plus 1. Therefore first term is 1. Now here if we put n is equal to 2 in un, so it will be minus 1 raised to 2 plus 1. So it will be minus 1 whole cube. So it will be minus 1. Therefore un is equal to minus 1 raised to n plus 1. Now here first of all we will find out S1. So S1 means sum of first term, so it will be 1. Then we will find out S2. So meaning of S2 is sum of first two terms. So here 1 minus 1, so it will be 0. Now we will find out S3. So meaning of S3 is sum of first three terms. So 1 minus 1 plus 1, so it will be 1. Now we will find out S4. So meaning of S4 is sum of first four terms. So it will be 1 minus 1 plus 1 minus 1. So it will be 0. So in general we can say that S2n is equal to 0. Because here you can see that S2 is equal to 0. Same way S4 is equal to 0. Same way if you find out S6 then it will be 0. Therefore in general we can say that S2n is equal to 0. And S2n minus 1 is equal to 1, because here you can see that S1 is equal to 1, same way S3 is equal to 1, same way if we find out S5 then it will be 1. So we can say that S2n minus 1 is equal to 1. So limit does not exist. Therefore the given series is oscillatory. Now we will discuss the convergence of the geometric series, that is a plus ar plus ar square plus ar cube plus so on plus ar raised to n minus 1 plus so on, and this is equal to sigma n equal to 1 to infinite ar raised to n minus 1, where a is not equal to 0. So here in this example we will discuss the convergence of geometric series. So here if r is equal to 1, then Sn is equal to a plus a plus a plus so on plus a. Because here if we put r is equal to 1 in this, so it will be a plus a plus a plus so on plus a. So this can be written as n times a. Now here we will apply n tends to infinite. So here this will be plus or minus infinite as n tends to infinite. So if r equal to 1, then Sn tends to plus or minus infinite as n tends to infinite. Therefore limit does not exist. So the series is divergent for r equal to 1. Now we will consider the second case. If r not equal to 1, then we have Sn is equal to a plus ar plus ar square plus ar cube plus so on plus ar raised to n minus 1. Now we will multiply Sn by r. So it will be r into Sn is equal to ar plus ar square plus ar cube plus so on plus ar raised to n minus 1 plus ar raised to n. Now we will subtract these equations. So subtracting these equations we will get Sn minus rSn is equal to a minus ar raised to n. So here Sn is common. So Sn into 1 minus r is equal to, here a is common, so it will be a into 1 minus r raised to n. Therefore Sn will be a into 1 minus r raised to n divided by 1 minus r. But for minus 1 less than r less than 1, we know that r raised to n tends to 0 as n tends to infinite. So limit n tends to infinite Sn is equal to limit n tends to infinite a into 1 minus r raised to n divided by 1 minus r. So if we simplify this, then it will be a divided by 1 minus r minus a divided by 1 minus r into limit n tends to infinite r raised to n. But here, for minus 1 less than r less than 1, r raised to n tends to 0 as n tends to infinite. Therefore, this will be 0. So, it will be a divided by 1 minus r. Thus, when modulus of r is less than 1, the geometric series is convergent and its sum is a divided by 1 minus r. For r less than equal to minus 1 or r greater than 1, the limit n tends to infinite, r raised to n does not exist. So, the geometric series is divergent for these cases. So, we will summarize geometric series. So, summary of geometric series. The geometric series is given by a plus ar plus ar square plus ar cube plus so on plus ar raised to n plus so on is equal to sigma n equal to 1 to infinite a into r raised to n minus 1, where a is not equal to 0. So this series is convergent if modulus of r is less than 1 and its sum is sigma n equal to 1 to infinite a into r raised to n minus 1 is equal to a divided by 1 minus r. And it is divergent for modulus of r greater than equal to 1. Now we will discuss example related to this. So, prove that 1 plus 2 divided by 3 plus 4 divided by 9 plus 8 divided by 27 plus so on is convergent and find its sum. So, rewriting the series in simple form as 1 plus 2 divided by 3 plus 2 divided by 3 whole square plus 2 divided by 3 whole cube plus so on is equal to sigma n equal to 1 to infinite 2 divided by 3 whole raised to n minus 1. Because here, if we put n equal to 1, then here it will be 2 divided by 3 whole raised to 1 minus 1. So, 2 divided by 3 whole raised to 0. So, it will be 1. Same way, if we put n is equal to 2, then here it will be 2 divided by 3 whole raised to 2 minus 1. So, it will be 2 by 3 whole raised to 1. So, we will get second term. So, which is geometric series with ratio r is equal to 2 divided by 3 and which is less than 1. Since modulus of r is less than 1, the series is convergent. And its sum is s is equal to a divided by 1 minus r. And here a is first term and first term is 1. So, s is equal to 1 divided by 1 minus 2 divided by 3. So, if we simplify this, then here 1 minus 2 divided by 3 will be 3 minus 2 whole divided by 3. So, it will be 1 divided by 3. So, it will be 3. Therefore, this series is convergent and its sum is 3. Now, we will discuss next example. Discuss the convergence of the geometric series sigma n equal to 1 to infinite 2 raised to n plus 5 whole divided by 3 raised to n. So here sigma n equal to 1 to infinite 2 raised to n plus 5 whole divided by 3 raised to n can be written as sigma n equal to 1 to infinite 2 divided by 3 whole raised to n plus 5 into 1 divided by 3 whole raised to n. So, this can be written as sigma n equal to 1 to infinite 2 divided by 3 whole raised to n plus sigma n equal to 1 to infinite 5 into 1 divided by 3 whole raised to n. Now, here if we put different values of n starting from 1, so here first term will be 2 by 3 raised to 1, so it will be 2 by 3. Then for second term, we will put n equal to 2 in this, so it will be 2 by 3 raised to 2. Same way for third term, we will put n is equal to 3, so it will be 2 by 3 raised to 3. Plus for fourth term, we will put n equal to 4, so it will be 2 by 3 raised to 4 plus so on. Then here plus 5 into, same way here we will put different values of n starting from 1. So here it will be 1 by 3 raised to 1, so it will be 1 by 3 plus 1 by 3 raised to 2 plus 1 by 3 raised to 3 plus 1 by 3 raised to 4 plus so on. So, both series are geometric series with ratio r1 is equal to 2 divided by 3 and ratio R2 is equal to 1 divided by 3. So here ratio of first series is 2 divided by 3 and ratio of second series is 1 divided by 3. And here for first series, first term is 2 divided by 3. So here A1 is equal to 2 divided by 3. And for second series, first term is 1 divided by 3. Therefore, A2 is equal to 1 divided by 3, respectively. So here modulus of R1 is less than 1 and modulus of R2 is less than 1. Hence, both the series are convergent. And S1 is given by A1 divided by 1 minus R1. So it will be 2 divided by 3 whole divided by 1 minus 2 divided by 3. So here if we simplify this, then here it will be 2 divided by 3 divided by 1 divided by 3. So 3, 3 cancel out. So it will be 2. Same way S2 is equal to A2 divided by 1 minus R2. So it will be 1 divided by 3 whole divided by 1 minus 1 divided by 3. So here if we simplify this, then here it will be 2 divided by 3. So here 1 divided by 3 whole divided by 2 divided by 3. So 3, 3 cancel out. So it will be 1 divided by 2. Hence its sum is S is equal to sigma n equal to 1 to infinite 2 raised to n plus 5 whole divided by 3 raised to n is equal to sigma n equal to 1 to infinite 2 divided by 3 whole raised to n plus 5 into sigma n equal to 1 to infinite 1 divided by 3 whole raised to n. So here we have found the sum of this series, that is 2 plus 5. We have also found sum of this series, that is 1 divided by 2. So here 2 plus 5 into 1 divided by 2. So if we simplify this, then here 5 plus 4 whole divided by 2. So it will be 9 divided by 2. So in today's lecture, we have discussed about convergence of series, then divergence of series, then oscillatory series, then telescoping series, and geometric series. Thank you for watching this lecture. I will see you in the next lecture.